Brothers and sisters, all of us know importance of good behavior, good manner, good conduct in Islam is so high. And the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَا مِن شَيْءٍ أَثْقَلَ فِي مِيزَانِ الْمُؤْمِنِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ مِنْ حُسْنِ الْخُلُقِ. Nothing will be heavier on the day of resurrection in the scale of the believer than good manners, good conduct. Another hadith, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, and أَكْثَرِ مَا يُدْخِلِ النَّاسِ الْجَنَّةِ فَقَالَ تَقْوَى اللَّهِ وَحُسْنُ الْخُلُقِ. He was asked about the deed which will be foremost to lead a man to Jannah, to paradise. He replied, fear of Allah and the good conduct. So this is the status of good character in Islam. It is most important good deed, you can see, most helpful for us in the Day of Judgment. Although we know importance of Salah, we do give priority, mashallah, and fasting, Hajj, Umrah, giving Sadaqah, all these are good. But you see what we need also in the Day of Judgment to make our scale of good deeds heavy? Through our conduct with other people. How we deal with other people. Our adab, our etiquettes, our good mannerism in our life. These are very important deeds. Sometimes you ignore these. We think Salah is very important. Yes, important. Hajj is important. Yes, it is important. But what about these behavior, dealing, conduct with each other? We sometimes consider it is good, but probably is not that important. Why hadith is giving us a very serious message about this. Among the good character today, we'd like to focus one or two things. One of the good character, that is to be humble to others. Humbleness is one of the good character which appreciated by Allah and his messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And opposite to that is arrogance, pride, ego, showing off, boasting oneself. These are opposite. It's very worst kind of behavior and character in one person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command us, and his command is obligatory, it's fard. He said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وَخْفِدْ جَنَاحَكَ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. O Prophet, and lower your wing to the believers. Even this command to the prophets. He was a prophet, he was humble. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala further emphasizing this. Although Allah made him leader of all mankind. أَنَا سَيِّدُ وَلَدِ Adam, وَلَا فَخَرْ. But I am not showing this pride, I am not proud of that. This is just information passing to us. As a prophet, and not only prophet, he is a leader of all prophets, Sayyidul Anbiya wal Mursaleen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him so humble with all this high status. Today, if we got a bit of a status, we are very concerned about our position and seeking it. And if we somebody that doesn't give the due position, due status to me, will be very upset. This is our character. The humbleness is so much important in our life. Rasul Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said again in the Quran, تِلْكَ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ نَجْعَلُهَا لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُرِيدُونَ عُلُوًا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فَسَادًا وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. That home of the hereafter, which is Jannah, which is paradise, we assign to those who do not desire exaltedness upon the earth or corruption. If you're looking for that high position, exaltedness, you should exercise some corruption to get it, to secure it, to keep it. So they are not doing all this. They are the one who deserve the paradise from Allah. And the best outcome is for the righteous. So the righteous, being righteous, to be righteous, we need to have this character, quality of humbleness in our life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said in the Quran, وَلَا تُسَعِّرْ خَدَّكَ لِلنَّاسِ وَلَا تَمْشِي فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ كُلَّ مُخْتَالٍ فَخُورٍ. In Surah Luqman, ayah number 18, and do not turn your cheek in contempt toward people, and do not walk through the earth. Do not walk through the earth exultantly, that you are looking for making yourself is high position with pride, boasting yourself. Inna Allah la yuhibbu kulla mukhtalin fakhur. Indeed, Allah does not like everyone self-deluded and boastful. In a hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إن الله أوحى إلي أن تواضعوا حتى لا يفخر أحد على أحد ولا يبغي أحد على أحد. Allah has revealed to me that you should humble yourselves to one another. One should neither hold himself above another nor transgress against another. This is command of Allah through wahi. If you do other way, you're disobeying Allah. He also said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, ما نقصت صدقة من مال وما زاد الله عبدا بعفو إلا عزة وما تواضع أحد لله إلا رفعه الله. Wealth does not diminish by giving charity. Allah increased the honor of one who forgives. When somebody does wrong to me, we would like to take revenge. We are very furious. We are very angry. Even sometimes, the people are coming to are seeking forgiveness will say, no, we are not forgiving you. That is sometimes, but if we forgive, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase our honor. And also, وَمَا تَوَادَ أَحَدٌ لِلَّهِ إِلَّا رَفَعَهُ اللَّهِ. And one who serves another, become humble to other person, seeking the pleasure of Allah, Allah will exalt him in ranks. To get higher position to Allah, to closer to Allah, being humble is a very good amal, very good deed in our lives. Example of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how he is humble to everybody. Anas radiallahu anhu says, مَرَّ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ عَلَى سِبْيَانٍ فَسَلَّمَ عَلَيْهِ. That once Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was going through a group of children who were playing probably in the street. He was passing by them and he was mocking, he was giving salam to them. It's not in one occasion. وَقَالَ كَانَ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ يَفْعَلُهُ. This was his habit. When he see the children, he used to give salam to them. He could say, I am senior, I am older, I am prophet, so you should give salam to me. No. Although you know adab of salam, the younger will give salam to the senior. That is our hadith, another hadith. Or the Sharia encourage us. However, we should not say, I am older, I'm senior position holder. That the other lower ranking people or junior people should give salam to me. I'm just waiting to tell them, wa alaikum salam. This is not the attitude of a righteous person. If it is that attitude, I'm just would like to say, wa alaikum salam, not assalamu alaikum, and I don't start, then this is not a good sign. This is a sign of arrogance, sign of pride. Many of our great scholars understood that very seriously. They were giving advice to us, that, and they are practicing these. Luqman alayhi salam, who was a pious person mentioned in the Quran, a surah is devoted for him, for his good advice, giving to his children. He said, Matiyatul Aqli At-Tawadu, the vehicle of the good wisdom is humbleness. Vehicle of the wisdom is humbleness. What does it mean? If you see a person is humble, presenting himself in a humble way, not self-boasting, then you can guess this man is a wise man. But if you find somebody is introducing himself with pride, with so much of his this and that status, would like to show off with many things, then this is a sign this man is not really a wise man. We know that. If I am boasting myself too much to you, you know, okay, we understood you. You don't need to talk anymore. That is the impression ourselves will make. So this is, it's not wisdom. This is stupidity. It doesn't, Allah doesn't like it. Even people don't like it. We know that. This is not wisdom. And even losing. And that will bring to us the kibir, the pride. And the pride is something very dangerous. Pride is something will deprive one from the Jannah. That's why hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, لا يدخل الجنة من كان في قلبه مثقال ذرة من كبر. The one in his heart, atom size of pride, arrogance, ego, all these are, this man will not enter Jannah. So we have to be very careful. Imam al-Awza'i rahmatullah alayhi said, أفضل الأعمال الورع وأفضل العبادة التواضع. The best ibadah is taqwa of Allah, to fear Allah, to obey Allah, and not to disobey Allah. This is the best kind of deed. And the best form of worship is at-tawadu, to be humble. So this is a beautiful character, an attitude, an habit, nature. If we can exercise it, and if we can be away from anything which will lead us to pride, to arrogance, to following our ego, all these will be dangerous for us in the Day of Judgment. Little bit of mithqal means atom size. Even atom size is pride, of pride is not tolerated by Allah. And he said in another hadith, Al-kibriya'u rida'i. The pride is my own dress. Whoever is showing this pride and arrogance, as if he is competing with me. Who can compete with Allah? Can challenge him? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us. Give us tawfiq. That we are saved from the pride, arrogance, showing off, and belittling others. May Allah make us, we are humble servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.